road alongside the concession stand, please come move your vehicles.
I hate to tell you this, but I'm counting the teams that are still left, and it's still a ways.
Okay, they're going to keep going even if you're out there on 10. You want to keep going even for Alex? Okay.
If, say that again?
They're going to keep going even if they're out to like 10, 20.
10 tonight?
Yeah.
No, we ain't going that long. Oh, no.
Like 7?
What time is it now, you know?
5:11.
Probably, yeah, 7, 7:30. This quarterback here is good.
On that team?
Yeah. It's throwing right now.
Come on, defense!
Well, we are back live. You never know what's going to happen out here at a state park. And as soon as we went live and people knew we were going live, pictures started going off of us, uploading, ate up our upload speed. But here we are. We're in the quarterfinals. You haven't missed much. A lot of action, a lot of high flyers. What we're watching out here right now are the Rat Pack out of Orlando, Florida. And you've got Rise Up. And I'll tell you, we've got some academic student-athletes out here on the Rack Pack. I'm looking at their GPAs, man. They're, you know, some of them are kicking up to 4.4. We're wired up out here, man. We're having a good time. And we're glad to be back with you. We apologize for all those people watching because we had to do some crazy technology. And when we sent that technology, we had to resend it out to our friend Jeff Fisher, California. We had to send it to Virginia. We had to send it to... We had to email it to everybody to put a new link on.
That was a great
and
pitch.
So they're working on it, and hopefully, you know, they've got it going on right now because we're going to get you that final game and the semifinal games, and we're going to also bring in the quarterfinals. And Ryan,
like with his fingernails,
160 broadcasts later,
just
piece of cake, right?
Absolutely. Always an interesting situation here out in the booth, but we always get figured out. We got some great games going on and got the sun right in our face, got a great tan line on my forehead right now. But once again, we got a couple games going on. As you can see, we got three cameras on three different fields. So once again, we got the live feed right now. I think you said it was the Rat Pack.
And yeah, Rat Pack. We got Rat Pack and Rise Up right in front of us.
To you as well.
Well, some of the impact players tonight on the Rat Pack. Number 11, look for Andre Williams. He's a university. He's a 3.4. Got number 21 you want to keep an eye on. Deion Edwards plays at Mignola. Migula, 2.5. Number 4, Kyle Panagotio. I'm sorry to butcher that. From Oviedo, 3.8 average. And a number 16, Nick Sproles out of Winter Park with a 4.4. This is the Rat Pack with Coach Charles Coe, who we interviewed earlier. If you want to contact Charles Coe, you can get him at ccoeiv@gmail.com. So here we go with some high-flying action with Rise Up. Some of the impact players of Rise Up. My sheet over here. Again, folks, I'm on the sideline with the rest of the team. The number one, the quarterback, Isaiah Alexander. He goes to Brandon High School, 2016 graduating year. Number 7, wide receiver, Jawan Jenkins, out of Manatee, 2017. Number 15, wide receiver, Isaac Johnson, out of Pasco, 2016. And number 65, Darian McNeil, out of Armwood.
Yes, sir.
Right in.
And we just got information over on field 1A, which is our camera 3 for you all. Right here is the NC Elite Preps versus YPL2. And we're going to send you over to Field 2A, which is Treasure Coast and Enhance as well. So we got three games going on for you folks, and we'll work it as much as possible. But we got our main camera on the Rat Pack.
Yeah, that was Marlon Gerald, number 7 for the Rat Pack, making the reception. It was only a 2-yard gain. It's third down, and they're going to have to score. They'll go into fourth down. It's a 40-yard field with an end zone, and we've got players all over the place. So we'll see what this quarterback can do to convert. Looking the inside, he's got a player wide open. That's a touchdown Rat Pack. And one of the coolest things we have out here today that you probably won't see on many of these Little League fields, because it is a rec field or a soccer field, we've got scoreboards. So Ryan, you know, those Ryan's got communication with our towers. We've got cameramen up on the towers. We'll be able to show you the scores.
Yep, not the biggest scoreboards in the world like you would expect at a high school stadium. But yes, they're at the north and south end of the football fields in the middle. So we'll get a chance to show you those scoreboards as well.
Going for the extra point right now. Looking to his left-hand side, wide open, and he's, he had it. Are they going to give it to him or not? It looks like they're giving each other high fives, so they're saying it was a completion into the end zone. Rat Pack scores, and I can't be down on that scoreboard. It's a little too far for me to see it, but we'll get a camera on it for you. And we appreciate you all hanging with us. We appreciate our street partners letting us know. We could hear our phones light up. And we've got a big team here right now that was telling us no audio, no this, no that. And we jumped on it, and we realized that our upload speed dropped like a rock. And the only way to take care of that was to just reconfigure it and send it out as a lower resolution. So sorry, folks, if you're watching on a 55-inch screen, it may be a little bit grainy. But, hey, a laptop, a phone, handheld, you're seeing it crisp as can be. Does a little slant pattern for a couple yards. Going to bring up third down and long ways. Rise up with the ball. Been a long day out here watching the preliminary rounds. A lot of folks out here, a lot of people taking notes. It's very interesting. Quarterback is looking left all the way. He dumps a short one out there, but he's going to bring up fourth down and a couple yards. That quarterback, Isaiah Alexander.
Timeout.
Out of Brandon. He's a 2016 grad. Once again, this is quarterfinal action.
Come to me.
Alexander's looking to the right-hand side. He's throwing a corner. Receiver's got a catch in the end zone. It's a touchdown. High-scoring contest, 7-on-7 action.
That quarterback throws the ball, right?
Get his number. Well, that's another interesting thing about 7-on-7 football. When we started getting all the rosters, we got rosters without numbers. So a lot of these teams don't play with numbers. And we're going to get them suited up soon with numbers if we're going to be broadcasting them live. So that young man didn't have a number on him. And so we can't let you know who it was. Extra point. Alexander looks to the middle. He throws it there, and it's a great catch with double coverage, and they're pressing him like crazy. A little shoving around. I'm surprised if a flag doesn't go. Rat Pack gets a little bit aggressive and a little physical. But hey, these guys want to win it just as bad. They're in single elimination right now, so you lose, you go home. some of these folks, it's a long ways. Got teams in here from Louisiana, Mississippi, North Carolina. Well, there's a referee that's walking somebody off. They're getting aggressive. Looks like the two coaches were meeting out there at the field. Got the players fired up to rise up. Rise up just scored. Rat Pack will take the ball. A lot of action, 7-on-7 football. There we go, Rat Pack. Rat Pack will take the ball. Well, that breeze is picking up. It warmed up to about 64 degrees. And then after that, as this sun starts to set in the west, we're going to have a little chill going, and I'm going to have to break out a big jacket. Rat Pack takes a ball on the offense. Rise up, just scores. Looks like Rise Up must have called a timeout here in the sidelines.
Yes, and the ambulance have finally made it. We got some, believe it or not, two-hand touch football can get pretty physical. Had a kid actually run over to the booth thinking it was the medic area. With a big gash in his head, so they're going to get him checked out.
Deep throw to the right-hand side. There's going to be a jump ball. Should have been picked off. They're definitely talking smack, Ryan.
Oh, yeah, they've been playing for a long time. I mean, these guys have been out here since 11 a.m. Number one, it's been cold all day. And number two, these guys, when you give them four games to get warmed up, we heard it right in the interviews, interviewing some of these coaches that didn't have very good records in the pool play. So these guys are looking to get after it. They know it's win or nothing. They leave. So these guys are going to get pretty physical. We've got some great teams. And when you're talking about the Southeastern Conference-type football, Georgia, Mississippi, you're going to get some attitude, especially from these Florida guys. There's just a rubber stamp right on their forehead saying, hey, look, you know, naturally, we just think we're the best. So we're gonna put it out there.
Well, Rat Pack brings it up. And it's a prevent defense. It's got to be fourth down. Throwing it up high, off and corner. Looks like it's picked off by Rise Up. Referees telling us that he was out of bounds. So they'll take over on downs. I can imagine, Ryan, if they're talking this much smack now in the quarterfinals, what it's going to be like.
Absolutely.
Well, semis and also in live, the final game.
Yeah, well, one of the biggest issues is these guys. It's not like a real football game, so these guys can walk out on the fields. The coaches are actually on the fields calling the plays most of the time, especially in the pool play. So there's no real barriers blocking them from getting real close to each other. So these kids, yeah, when they're out there in the end zone, they're going after it. They're definitely going to exchange a couple words, and I think that's it for the game. In front of us, we got a couple more games going on. We're going to shoot around and see what kind of action we got going on in some other areas. Once again, we got three different games going on.
All right, so that
well, we just had one
there,
finish up.
Team here.
Yes, sir. And
game
the game
ends,
you're watching
there,
right
so
now
three,
is actually Treasure Coast and Enhanced. So, and on the other field is NC Elite Preps versus the YPL2. So we got two games going on. We're looking forward to getting the next one.
And I'm not sure, Ryan, who won that last one, but we, you know, we'll get caught up here. Once we get caught up, got sweet Erica right here running around getting me numbers of players and impact players and putting them on my clipboard. And I am literally down here at field level. So I'm trying to watch it. cords don't go flying. And I'm kind of wired up here, and you know, we get teams that finish. It's very interesting.
Absolutely. And in saying that, we're going to take a quick break. Ladies and gentlemen, stay with us. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, this broadcast today is brought to you by and made possible by some of the greatest sponsors and partners out there. First and foremost, the KDA Foundation, the Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation. You can follow them on social media at KDA Productions. Also, you can check out and find out more information at www.kdafoundation.org. Once again, big shout out to our main sponsors today, Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation. Big shout out to PTRG. PlayingTheRecruitingGame.com. You can also follow them on social media at Recruiting Game, the first patent web-based learning management system that teaches student athletes to apply a business approach to the recruiting process. We give a big shout out to them. And last but never least, the infamous StealthRating.com. Acronym stands for Students Taking Education, Athletics, and Life to Heart. You can follow them at Stealth Ranking on Twitter, and also to find out more information and to check out one of our live broadcasts of the last camp and combine, you can find that at www.stealthrating.com. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is Ryan Stout alongside Glenn Stout here at the First Coast Invitational here in Jacksonville, Florida. Had a great day so far. Showcase started at 11 a.m. this morning. I think we've been out here since 7:30 getting set up. But 20 different teams from multiple states in the Southeastern Conference, Mississippi, Georgia, Florida, you name it, they're here. And they got a lot of attitude, and they're looking forward to winning some games. We are in the single elimination round, and we got Glenn Stout right on the sideline. He's got cords hanging around all over the place, but he's bringing the live action to you right now. You can see we're on field 2A with Treasure Coast and Enhance. We just finished up with a great team, and someone got eliminated.
Yeah, and we're not sure on the first one because we came in and out, and I want to give another shout out because I'm not sure you all got it earlier. It was infamous that you're out here with this high-profile teams and everybody and their mother. When we went live, they realized we were going live, and they started taking pictures and uploading. So we had to reconfigure, and we got some partners out there that had to change up all their links and everything else, and I'm hoping they have it all done now, and that could be Jeff Fisher out there in California, Los Angeles, California, high school football. HighSchoolFootballAmerica.com. And then once again, we've got Bob Smith up the Virginia area, nation's best, the guru of social media, nation's best football. And we always have our one and only Lazaro Suarez, who provides the graphics for us. He's down in Miami, Florida. That's Bleacher.com, B-L-E-E-C-H-R.com. And we've got a couple new partners that we want to let you know about. Bob Winstead and Emerson Martin with NYFO, National Youth Football Organization, Big League Play in North Carolina, and PlayersToPros.com. Exciting things happening with our organization, High School Programming Network, HSPN, partnering up. Going to bring you live events all over the country. giving exposure to all of those athletes flying under the radar and making sure that they get a great education for all the work that they put in. Well, we're out here. We've got another couple teams that are coming into the quarters. I know we've got the Hornets, coached by T. Lee. It's a local Jacksonville team. And I can see Erica coming my way. I know we've got a camera lined up on a little scoreboard. I'm not sure if the folks stand out of the way. You know, Ryan will direct in this thing. You might be able to catch that score for you. I've got sideline passes, man. I'm standing out here with all the wires and players walking in and out and looking at me, and one of them gave me a high five. And so this is cool. I thought a high school press box was tough. Forget about it. Get on the sideline of a 7-on-7 event and walk around with about 16 wires and people coming up when you're talking into the microphone. Yeah. So yeah, it's interesting.
No break. It doesn't get much better than that. And we got a whole new round of elimination, single elimination competitions going on. We're going to get these names for you. We got over on 1A. Great game going on right now. We're going to let you get back to that.
Well, I'm starting to get the information, and we're actually starting a competition as well here on Field B right in front of us. So as soon as I get that information, we will forward it to you as well. We've got cameras all over the place, so I'm sure you're getting shots of the games that are being played on all four of the fields. Well, we've got Rise up in front of us again, so they obviously won that last game and then single elimination. And once again, the impact players will rise up as number one, the quarterback, Isaiah Alexander from Brandon High School. And he's a graduate of 2016.
That's the smallest team out here.
Number seven, the wide receiver, Jawan Jenkins. He's out of Manatee in 2017. And I've got number 15, the wide receiver, Isaac Johnson from Pasco, 2016. And number 65, Darian McNeil out of Armwood. So we will get the... We've got the games going live. We'll get the other team with us in just a minute. And, man, I'll tell you, something very interesting is going on. I hear a phone ringing in one ear. And Ryan is back there getting ready to bring in one of our guests. He's getting ready to bring in a guest speaker, a guest from one of our locations around the country. And then you'll hear Ryan in a dialogue with the guest. We're gonna hit the folks from South Florida all the way out to California, and hopefully they're around. We're about an hour and a half delayed because of the round robin. It was delayed in itself, and then whatever else issues. So we do have Rise up in front of us, and Isaiah is back, and he's throwing it right over the middle, and it's a pick. That'll be some points for the team. We'll find out the name here shortly. Okay, well, we're getting ready to take that call. Enjoy the action. You're getting ready to hear a live interview from Ryan Stout and Lazaro Suarez. Because I heard his voice, I will be back with you. I'm on the sideline. This is Glenn Stout with HSPN Sports.
Yes, sir. Got Bleacher.com in on the call. We're going to bring him up. Lazaro, can you hear us? Oh, we're doing great. We're here on the sidelines, getting a little crazy. But, hey, it's not a... It's not the worst thing that we could do. How's everything going down south in the MIAL?
Good. Not too bad. As a matter of fact, we were here today, and it was probably about 78 degrees and raining.
78?
I'm looking at 78 degrees and raining.
Oh, my goodness.
But you know, everything got a little bit better. But I'm looking at the feed here now on the website, and it looks great, man. It looks great. I know it was a little chilly this morning.
Oh, man, 49 degrees. We got out here at 7:30 a.m. and the chill factor was in. Hey, we were going to jump right into it. Wanted to start the dialogue and just talk about the relationship that we've had, not only with Bleacher.com and all the things that you've done for HSBN, but we're just going to jump right into it. And I got a couple questions that I'm going to throw your way and answer as you please. How's that sound?
Nobody.
Sounds good.
All right. Number one, what is the biggest impact you've seen with HSBN Sports having on the student athletes that we've been covering?
Oh, a fourth pick.
Oh, man. It's basically shining a spotlight on kids that otherwise would never see the light of day. By having your broadcast on constantly, you bring into light more and more kids on here that don't make the top 10 or 20, you know, in the paper, you know, on the news channels. But you're basically bringing them on the web and to social media, and then a lot of these kids are getting noticed, and it's turning into scholarships, man. It's a great opportunity.
Absolutely. And we have, just a great brand that you've created with Bleacher, and we're going to give you a chance to talk a little bit about Bleacher and what you've been doing. But I want to ask you, you know, we've been partnered up the past season. What are some of the benefits as the broadcasting? What has it really done for Bleacher.com being on the broadcast?
No, again, it's basically expanding the brand. I mean, the fact that it's a targeted audience, you're dealing with student athletes, you're not mixed in with, you know, with some of the other sports at different levels. It's very focused. It's very targeted. And that's exactly what we, you know, what we're looking for and then what you guys deal with. So, you know, it's been a fruitful partnership thus far, and I'm looking forward to continuing it.
Well, absolutely. And Bleacher.com, some outstanding things that people want to know. What really separates Bleacher from the rest?
Everything and anything from youth to high school football. We don't really get involved with other sports. We have a love for football. There's a huge market out there that, you know, that loves what we're doing. And we're basically a lot of people follow us just for that. We keep it simple. We keep it pure. And that's pretty much what we do. And just like HSBN, is just bring more attention to these kids and get them noticed. Ultimately, it's exposure is the name of the game.
Awesome. And so let's talk about some future plans. We know you got some things lined up behind the scenes. We won't give away too much, but what's some things you got going on for Bleacher in the future?
Yeah, actually, there's a lot of things planned for this year, as a matter of fact. We've been kind of like a closely knit, a closely kept secret down here in South Florida. What we're doing is expanding throughout the state and then throughout the country. And we'll be rolling that out pretty soon, within the next few weeks or so. So, you know, be on the lookout for that.
Awesome.
And obviously HSPN, self-rating, ring, you know, all that, you're all part of it, included in the rollout. So looking forward to it.
Hey, man, we appreciate you not only tuning in, but everything that you're doing for these student-athletes. And if anyone wanted to contact you right now, where would they get in touch with you? Or any more information?
Yeah, absolutely. You go to bleacher.com, BLEETHR.com. Or you can email us at info@bleacher.com. We keep it simple.
Absolutely. And social media, ladies and gentlemen, everyone's on social media. You can find him on Twitter, at BLEECHR, Bleacher. Instagram as well. I believe it's the same name.
Yeah. Instagram, Twitter, Google+, Pinterest. We're everywhere. It's at Bleacher, BLEECHR.
Awesome. Hey, Laz, thanks so much for tuning in. We're glad that you're watching the stream with us, and we're glad that you got the stream running on the website, man. We just appreciate all you do, and we're looking forward to getting back south with that warm weather.
You got it, Ryan. Thanks for bringing me on.
Absolutely, man. Talk to you later. Have a good one.
You too.
All right, you still there, Laz?
Well, we've got live action right in front of us. We finally got the name of the team that has the black uniforms on. They are Belglade. They have no further information, but obviously Rise Up made it to the second round because they're in there. There's been a couple of picks, and Belglade is getting, you know, is having a hard time moving the ball. But that's what we got. You know, we're going to fight it out here till the end, and these coaches are getting fired up. I almost have the sun literally down above the tree line in my eyes, and I know I'm going to go for a jacket soon.
Yeah, it looks pretty brutal. I had to find my jacket, and good thing I got these this equipment in front of my face, or else that tan line. I can't wait to walk into church tomorrow with the big old sunburn on my face and the white forehead. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, that was Lázaro Suárez. We're glad he got to tune in with us right in on the phone conference coming from the big MIA, Miami, Florida. doing some outstanding things with the student athletes. And I know we can talk about Laz all day, especially Glenn, you know, the relationship that we've built, not only through the foundation, but everything that we've done, not only a great business partner, but a personal friend as well.
Well, Isaiah's looking down the left-hand side. He's throwing it up in the corner, and it's overthrown. You're absolutely right. Lazaro has done some phenomenal things for us, and he also works with Nation's Best with Bob, and the graphics are just phenomenal. I mean, he does that, and he does it very well, and now he's his website is hosting tournaments for people that because he has the capability of doing that. It's just wonderful to see the growth. I mean, I remember at the Miramar game, we had him wired up on the sideline. And that wasn't the most comfortable place for him to be. But, man, Lazaro showed up, and he'd already done the graphics. He ran, got in the car, and rode up to Miramar, and bam, he was doing that for us. And incredible graphics that we have going on. And, hey, I hear the phone ringing again. We're going to bring in another guest. So, you know, we got Rise up here. I can't see the scoreboard, but this is going to happen real soon, and you know, we're just warming you guys up. We're going to warm you up for the big game, and everybody is getting warmed up down here, and I'm excited to see all these players around, a lot of collegiate players.
Did you hear me talking to Lazaro?
Wow. Big hit by Belglade. Came right over the top of him. It was a little throw over the middle, and Rise up. It's an incompletion. And boy, oh boy, the wind's picking up. And I know you folks up north, you're probably laughing at me because 64, I don't think it's 64 anymore, but you've got these thin-blooded South Florida folks up here. And looking at these kids, though, they're really running around. They're sweating like crazy. Looks like he had too much time on the clock. That's going to be a called down because he's got to get rid of that ball within 4 seconds. That's the rule in this 7-on-7 play. Well, I just got word that we've got one of our strategic partners that is doing a phenomenal job with the social media, Bob Smith in Virginia, and I'm going to give it to you, Ryan, take it over and talk to another one of our strategic partners up in North Virginia.
Yes, sir. Got Bob Smith, Nation's Best Football, on the line. We're going to bring him up. Bob, can you hear us?
Can hear you good. Thanks, Ryan.
Yes, sir. Live action here from Jacksonville. We're freezing our tails off. How are you doing out there? Are you feeling any cold weather?
Well, I'm looking outside the window, and we got about 4 inches of snow. So it's kind of nice seeing the sunshine and everybody playing on grass.
Well, I guess
we're very envious.
I guess I shouldn't be complaining in the 49-degree weather. We still can see the grass on the ground. But ultimately, thank you for joining us today. I know you're sitting at the house or wherever you're sitting, and you're watching the stream. How's it look so far? Tell us about it.
Well, it looks like you guys are having a great day. I see a lot of good catches being made by the receivers and some nice passes. And it's also very nice to see the attendance of the fans on the sidelines. Looks like it's a good tournament today.
Absolutely. We've been having a great time. Like we said earlier on, we've been out here literally all day, and the guys are really getting into it. It's unfortunate we can't get that sideline action to our viewers, but these kids, they're going after it. They've been playing a lot of football all day, but we're going to give a chance. We want to jump right into it. Nation's Best Football. Give our listeners a little background. You know, we've had conversations, previous conversations on not only Nation's Best, but your background as well. Let's give the audience a little background on your media and journalist sports career.
Well, appreciate it, Ryan. Nation's Best Football, we're in our fifth year, and we showcase all levels of football, youth, high school, college, and pro. And we showcase players, coaches, the things that are important, equipment, sponsors, and then as well as the families and fans that make it such a great game.
Right. Now, what we really want to know is the influence. What got you so involved in high school sports in the first place?
Well, we're a football company, and I've been a member of the NFL media for close to 25 years, and I've enjoyed covering football at all levels. And locally, we've got great scholastic football here in Virginia, and an opportunity to work with one of our spokesmen, Coach Rich Survey, who just got inducted into the Virginia High School Hall of Fame after 30 years at Jacksonville High School, won a few state championships. So it's really an honor to cover those guys and all the players that go to D1 every year from their program. And, you know, we have a chance to showcase not only the local players, but with the programs we do on a national basis, we can feature some of the good players around the country.
Well, that is outstanding. What are some of the things Nation's Best is focusing in its efforts right now?
Well, you know, we've been doing this now for 5 years, and obviously the explosion with mobile media has been really exciting. And, you know, when we started, everybody was looking at content over their laptop, over their desktop computer. It's all phone now. So for us, it's great. And we, our specialty is Instagram. If you go on our Instagram, you'll see we have close to 17,000 followers. And every day it's really exciting because we get to shout out the best pictures and videos of football players at all levels, as well as feature edits and artwork from some very talented artists from around the country that use a lot of apps on their mobile phones.
Right.
And then, of course, it's great working with the NFL and the other leagues to showcase their product to the fans.
Now, speaking of Instagram, we actually have your website page up right now and talking about some followers, 16.7K. And as you're talking about these pictures, some outstanding stuff going on. Any thing in particular? You got all types of athletes. You got some NFL. You got some college athletes. Are these pictures that you all are creating, or pictures that are being sent in? I see you also got some bleacher tags on there as well.
Well, we're really lucky because when we started our Instagram, we had some really good people that showcased their content on Instagram, and they said, hey, just do shout-outs. And so when we started asking people to send us pictures and send us their artwork, send us videos, and it kind of blew up from there. You know, every day we have lots of pictures that we showcase. We pick the best one. So any of you football players out there that want to get recognized, just DM us your picture, and we do the rest. We've got our Nation's Best shout-out template that we lay on top of the picture. We add some hashtags, and as you can see now, you know, a picture of a high school football player gets, you know, anywhere from 300-plus likes, a couple dozen comments. And with the hashtags, they're forever on those threads for people to see. So,
awesome.
If somebody doesn't see your picture today, they may see it a week from today, a month from today.
Right.
But, you know, we're all about showcasing what players are doing.
Well, that's just outstanding, and we've had previous conversations, and we're so glad we're able to team up on this 7-on-7 event, and we got some action right in front of us. They're running by us. Once again, Bob, we really appreciate you coming on the broadcast. We really appreciate everything you're doing, not only for us, but for the student-athletes around the nation. It's a real passion for both of us. And also, once again, ladies and gentlemen, Nation's Best Football. You can follow them social media at Nation's Best FB. Bob, we really appreciate you coming in. And any last words for our audience?
Just want to thank you, everybody, for tuning in today and watching some great 7-on-7 at the tournament. And, you know, we really appreciate what you guys are doing with the Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation and the things that you guys are doing with HSTN Sports. You know, like Lazaro Suarez from Bleacher said before me, you know, you guys have given a great platform for players to be showcased not only locally, but regionally and nationally, and that's what it's all about. And, you know, thanks again for a chance to be a part of today's event.
Absolutely. Thanks again, Bob. Once again, we're going to get back to this live action. Glenn, we're gonna send it over to you.
Yeah, we're back to live action, and my goodness gracious, it was great to hear Bob, and it's fantastic to get him on the line, and wow, 3 feet of snow or whatever it was, my goodness gracious. We had some high flyers just come by here. They're getting physical, and we finally got some names of some of these Belgrade players. It's we got Luangia, Kevin Lones, Corey Anelkan, Brian George, Antavius Turner, and Roderick Martin, it looks like. So we're getting this information in for you folks. This is the first time for them. They'll get used to it. They'll get used to having us around. And, you know, I'm not sure if we'll go sideline. We may get me up in a tower next time because it's a little bit physical, and it's been a long time since I've been out on a football field. But these guys are jacked up. I got the Hornets, man, right in front of me, and the Hornets are just jumping all over the place, ready to get out there and chew up somebody. And I'll tell you who's fired up. This Belgrade coach is fired up. They've got to be leading in this game. There's a deep ball down the left-hand side, and wow, almost a fantastic catch. And these guys are getting in the face. I am really getting excited about this final game because it is going to be physical. I'm not looking forward to the sun going down, though.
Yep.
This was supposed to end up a little earlier.
Well, they can see it in the camera shot. That sun just barely touching the top of the screen. But, yes, it is. The chill factor has approached, again, 49 degrees this morning. Some would say it's great football weather. But, hey, we feel for, you know, Bob talking about he's got 4 inches of snow outside his window. So I guess we can't complain too much.
Hey, and somebody's going to be bringing me a jacket pretty soon. I can tell you that because it is chilly over here. Well, Belgrade has the ball, as you can see, on the prime time field. Nice quick post touchdown, Belgrade. And that was a ball zipped in there, baby. Nice, nice threat on that ball. Little simple post pattern. And the corner let him come through right in front of him. And the ball was thrown right in front of him, and it's a touchdown, Belgrade. Looks like maybe 2 minutes left in this game. I'm looking at the scoreboard, and it looks like it's a 15-14 game. And I think Belgrade just scored. There's a conversion. Nice throw. High in the center. Got it to his tall player. And I'll get a scoreboard for us right now. And I can hear we've got another interview getting ready to come on. I can hear the phone conversation. It's really cool. I'm being squeezed in here by Marion players. Maybe they'll throw a jacket over here at me and warm me up. But this is a close ball game right here, folks. Ryan, I don't know if one of your cameras has it, but I think it's a 16-15 or a one-point game. Rise Up has the ball again, and he's going to get called for a delay. And it's going to bring up second down and long. But, yeah, it looks like this is a one-pointer or a two-pointer if I can see the scoreboard over there clear enough. And this game is going to go down to the wire.
Yes, sir. Great game going on right now. And we just got a call in from Jeff Fisher with High School Football America. We're going to bring him up and see if we get him going. Jeff, can you hear us?
Sure can. How you doing, guys?
We're doing great. The sun is going down. We're getting colder and colder. But just like Bob said over at Nation's Best, we can't complain too much because at least we don't have snow on the ground.
we don't have it in Laguna Beach either. We have 79 degrees.
Oh, man. What I'd kill for a nice 70-80-degree weather transition right now. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is Jeff Fisher with High School Football America tuning in with us. Jeff, how's it going?
It's going real well today. I'm watching a little bit. I had to get out of in front of the internet, but it looks like you guys are having a good time there today.
Oh, we're having a blast. Got some great competition going on. The Southeastern Conference is you know, guys from Mississippi, Georgia, South Florida, North Florida. It's a very unique and it's just a great atmosphere of football. We've had a chance to interview some athletes, and they're just fired up. We're running a little behind because of the pool play. They got four games each, but single elimination round. I know you got a chance to tune in a little bit. What were your thoughts when you got a chance to tune in?
But, you know, the thing that I love about it is the enthusiasm, even in, you know, early March, to see these kids just jacked up. Obviously, out here in California, we have a little bit of a delay until we get into our passing tournament, but we're expecting the same sort of thing. And like I said, the wonderful thing is to see the sport be year-round at this point, and the fact that these kids are just, you know, going at it hard and heavy. It's it doesn't count like it does come August, September, and October, but the enthusiasm's there, and that's what I noticed.
Absolutely. Football, you know, as a former athlete myself, I used to tell my friends, you know, season's all year-round. And especially when you're in an area such as Laguna, you know, out in California and South Florida, you can play all year round. But we want to jump right into it. High School Football America, we're going to throw some stuff. I know we had previous conversations, but 14 years old at a radio station. Let's talk about it. Give us a little background, Jeff, and some of the passions you got going on and just some of the things that we've talked about in previous conversations for the audience out there.
Yeah, we, you know, we have a passion for this sport, and I think that's been the theme throughout with everybody that's, you know, coming into your network at HSPN and all that. But, you know, I started when I was 14. I had a mentor who's still doing radio at this his age. He's 80 years old. He put me on the air, and my first thing that I ever did was an Easton High School football game in Pennsylvania. It's right on the Delaware River, about 40 miles north of Philadelphia. They've won 800 games. They're one of those top all-time programs. And from that moment on, I was just addicted to it. And, you know, luckily for me, I've had the ability to, throughout my life, to move up the ladder and, you know, got to work for Fox Sports in Chicago and the Bay Area and Ohio. And, you know, all along, I was missing the high school angle. While it's cool to go into the scoreboard at Wrigley Field, high school sports still my love, my passion. And, once that kind of got wrapped up in 2002 or three, I started working on this goal of taking high school sports that I covered for a long time and created a lot of things along the way and making my own business. And myself and my partner, Trish Huffman, started High School Football America. It's had many different forms, but our goal is to do what you guys do. It's four simple things: promote student athletes, promote coaches, promote schools, and therefore you promote communities. So, we do that well. We think that everybody's happy. The website is highschoolfootballamerica.com. Kind of our marquee project is our radio show. We came to Los Angeles to do that with Fox Sports Radio.
Right.
And we have an internet radio show that gets 50,000 downloads every Thursday night. So hopefully that was 12 years condensed into 2 minutes.
Yes, it was. And as I look at the call sheet, you know, I'm sitting here laughing because one of the things you mentioned in previous conversations, saying your voice grew up before your body. And I can only imagine, 14 years old, we, as High School Programming Network, that HSPN, that's what it stands for, and interning high school students is always a trip. We love putting the kids behind the cameras and in front of the mics, but you never really know what to expect as a high schooler. So I can only imagine at 14 years old getting the opportunity like yourself.
Yeah, and that's why I really like what you guys are doing at HSPN, because that's really the core of what I've been able to do. I've had a blessed career where I've been able to do a lot of things, but if it wasn't for my crazy mentor with the crazy idea that I could actually do it, you know, who knows what would have happened. And I've tried to carry that on through my career. I've been fortunate enough to give a lot of people internships or just hiring them for their first jobs a lot of opportunity. I just had one young man who never had been on television. I hired him in Philadelphia, and he was a big guy in Detroit and just got a job in Boston. So that's the sort of stuff that makes you smile, and I think you guys are doing the right thing by giving the kids real hands-on experience. One thing that I always try to tell people when they go for internships, yeah, it might be great to go to some big station, but you don't need to be carrying cups of coffee around the talent. What you need to be doing is have hands-on opportunities, and that's what we've always tried to do, and I think that's what you guys are doing, so we just appreciate what you're doing.
Absolutely, and as I'm sitting here looking, you know, coming from the pro ranks, you know, you're saying it's fun, but, you know, your passion's really high school students, student-athletes, and, you know, I got a couple stats here. 1,000 games in 14 different states. You talk about some traveling. You know, we've gone up to Tennessee maybe once or twice, but Jacksonville is probably our reach. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, you know, it's funny. I think some of it's just a just what happens when you move a lot, because the business causes you to move a lot. But I've also gone out of my way to see them. Probably the most recent thing that we've done, and we're kind of cutting a lot of video now to go up on the website at highschoolfootballamerica.com. Trish and I took a 35-day trip that began on October 29th in Laguna Beach, and we went all the way across the country to Charleston, South Carolina, in between. Our daughter got married in Atlanta. Then we went up to D.C. and New York, and then we were going to go all the way through Chicago and up and around, but it got a little too cold. So we went 35 days, 19 states, 7,500 miles, and saw a lot of high school football games and stadiums in between. And, you know, what you find, and I get this question all the time, is Arizona and New Mexico different than Texas or Pennsylvania or Georgia or Illinois? And the answer is yes and no. I think that the biggest difference is you just have fewer really, really top programs in these smaller states. But the passion, what goes on, I think the best way I could summarize it is one of the stops we made on our trip was in a Hopi Indian reservation tribe, where it was a Hopi tribe high school that plays in the Arizona Interscholastic Athletic Association, right, taking on a team from the Navajo Nation. And both teams had about 13 players. Both teams had girls on the team. And the enthusiasm of the players and the enthusiasm more so of the fans was no different than going to a Texas championship game where I've been in 50,000. Maybe a little bit quieter, but the enthusiasm is there. Right.
Well, Jeff, actually, we got your website page, High School Football America. We got it up right now, and I'm pretty sure we got your mug shot up. Is that you behind the mic?
Yeah, somewhere there, I guess. I don't know what you're looking at, but I'm somewhere on there. Yeah. I think my mug's on there somewhere.
There we go. Well, we're on the front page of the website, and for the viewers, as they can see, you know, I'm scrolling through, and you know, some great stuff. Anything that we want to point out? The viewers in the right direction?
Yeah, I think, you know, maybe three things. The one is the radio show that I talked about, which you can see on our website there. We have an audio tab. We do the show once a week, 7 o'clock Eastern time, and we've had great coaches. We've had a who's who on there. There's no coach that anyone, depending what part of the country you're in, if you've heard of that guy, we've had him on the show. So we do that. We do a daily podcast called The 2-Minute Drill that you can find on the website. The third thing is we try to break out the news from all 50 states and D.C. by section, so you can kind of navigate easily. And then the final thing that we started 2 months ago, and this would be more for the coaches, we have a coaches job board that has absolutely exploded our traffic and exploded as far as what coaches see we're all about as far as being about them. So we, in a matter of 2 months, put up 450-plus jobs. They're everything from, you know, the head coach jobs, the DC and OC jobs, assistants, break down into middle school and the grade school level.
Wow.
And right now there's 252 active up there, so you can go on, and we try to make it easy for you to apply. It's free. So if coaches want to list their staff openings, they can reach out to me at jeff@highschoolfootballamerica.com. And we just think it's a cool thing, and it's our way of supporting the coaches and trying to support this great sport we all love.
Awesome. Well, Jeff, we really appreciate not only what you're doing on with everything High School Football America and everything you got going on. You got some great content, and literally we could do this all day, and we actually, you
we
know
could.
It's some great content. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna point them in the right direction. That's www.highschoolfootballamerica.com. We went through the website with you, and you can also follow them on social media at HSFB America. Once again, that's at HSFB America. Jeff, we thank you so much again for coming on. We're glad that you're streaming on the website. I saw it as I scrolled down. You got the little embedded tab. So for those viewers tuning in from High School Football America, we appreciate you joining us today. And, Jeff, any last words for the viewers?
Kind of reiterating what I said at the top, which is, you know, proud to be a part of doing this and streaming it. We got a little late start this week, but by next week's we'll have a nice page dedicated to live there. And we just keep up the good work of promoting kids. That's the most important thing in this world today. We need more positive news than negative, and you guys are going to have to thank a lot.
Well, thank you, Jeff, and I'm sure we'll get on the phone later on sometime today. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Fisher with High School Football America. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll keep working. And once again, that was Jeff Fisher with High School Football America. We got you back live on the sideline. I see you got a chair and a jacket.
You're darn right. I got a chair and a jacket. They better bring this. I brought this big Sully out from Lake Tahoe because that daggone sun's getting ready to host. And let me tell you, Ryan, it is turned up about 10 degrees or 100 degrees and momentum here. Rise Up just won their second game. And, man, they were high-fiving. They were going crazy. And they're getting ready to take a little rest on the sidelines. I'm not sure if I want my players, but they got these sleeveless, and they don't seem like they're affected at all. They got adrenaline going. They're young. We got in front of us right now on the main field 2B. We've got Team Florida getting ready to play the Hornets, and Team Florida is out of St. Petersburg. The Hornets, hometown team, they're going on defense first. What a great conversation that you had earlier with Jeff Fisher out there in Los Angeles, California, and he's killing me with the 71, but we'll get back at it tomorrow. And there we go, a little underneath pass. He makes it to the corner. He makes a touchdown. He gets down about the referee's going to give it to him to the three-yard line. Let me give you some of the impact players from Team Florida today. It's number one, DeJon Johnson. He's 2016. Got Jalen, number two, Jalen Williams. He's a 2018. That's got to be a freshman. And you got number eight, Austin Casey. He's 2017 grad. Number 21, Jimmy Fox. He's a 2016. And then number 24, Nate Dimmitt. He's a 2016. And that is the Team Florida impact players. On the other side of the gamut, the Hornets. Let's watch this play. A little roll to the right. He's going to throw a little dump pass, and he's in the end zone for a touchdown. Corner doesn't come up fast enough, and he dumps one off for a touchdown. And the Team Florida goes up first. Now, if I can stay with them, I can add it and do the math for you without having to squint to see all the way across the field, but I'm sure you got that covered. They're going for the extra point right now. Some of those impact players on Team Florida, number seven, DeJon Jackson. Number eight, Devontae Lawrence. Number four, Devontae Harrison. Number 12, Billy Gaines. And I interviewed Billy Gaines earlier. I remember that name. Number one, Rajon Peterson. Number 14, Jacoby Feliciano. Interviewed him too. Number zero, who was talking all kinds of smack with me over here on the sideline, John Singleton. I'm going to see if Johnny can live up to the hype. Number 15, Jamal Padgett. Number 17, Tyron Baxter. Number 11, Dennis Livers. Number six, Willie Lee. And Willie Lee, number six, is an eighth grader, folks. So I'm looking forward to see how this eighth grader shows out. He must be one heck of an athlete. If you want to contact the Hornets, you can check them out at Hornets7v7.com with head coach, Coach T. Lee. Well, the Hornets have the ball on offense, and I'm going to get a lane here, though I can see. And we've got a live feed going, so we're going to get a lane. Thank you, guys. The Hornets have the ball. They bring the ball back. And let's see what the Hornets, the first time we've seen the Hornets today. They got 4 seconds to throw the ball, and looks like they're stop and play again. Not sure what the holdup is. But we got some cool stuff. I'll tell you, man, you got Bob Webster up on that tower with Jordan Van Dyke, a young stud out of St. Joe High School, running back, going to be a senior, and he is going to do it to him. We've got all the way across the field that's shooting the other games. His brother, Justin Van Dyke, he's on the other tower. Behind the controls is Ryan Stout directing everything. We've got our team here from Analogic that does all of our back-end development, Rich and Chris. And we've got Janaea Van Dyke, who's been doing our social media We've got Erica Lane, who is unbelievable, our engineer, and puts together all of this madness that we do. And she's running around trying to get rosters for me and getting impact players. And that is just a piece of our team. We picked up a couple of them on the phone, and I know that you're going to get another one.
Yeah, we got some more coming in.
Good, and, beautiful.
We're going to get some things worked out, but had to switch a couple cameras around because that sun is no joke.
Well, Team Florida has the ball. A little swing pass out here. Picks up a couple. But that was interesting because the Hornets had the ball, and now they're on defense. So I'm not sure what happened, but they didn't have the ball for long. And Team Florida scored first. I'm trying to catch the score over there. Maybe 8-0. I'm alternating hands with the mic.
I have to get some gloves.
Yes. Throw over the middle. He's going to try to get it to the edge, and he brings it down in here to about the 12-yard line. That is number 11 for Team Florida. And let's see if we got something on him. Yes, we do. That is Brayton O'Connell. He's a 2016 student athlete. Team Florida came right down here in front of me. So if the cameras followed him, you may have seen me down here, the one that's shivering in a big brown jacket.
Yeah, we also want to give a shout-out, ohboysports.com. That is the tent we are broadcasting from right now. Got a name for it, the Oh Boy Sports Media Tent, bringing you all the live action. I know you can see in the camera angles as they pan over the HSBN. We got the scaffolds going, and right to the left of the scaffold is the Oh Boy Sports Tent, showing us some love. Didn't have any rain today, but now we're broadcasting from the ohboysports.com media tent. So big shout out to Oh Boy Sports.
Just saying goodbye to Rich and Chris from Analogic coming out here and making sure that we got that stream up for you as fast as we could. Deep down the left-hand side, receivers wide open. It looks like number one catching that ball for the Florida, Team Florida, Dejon Johnson. That's about a 40-yarder, and he takes it in for the score. That's a second score for Team Florida. And I'm telling you, boy, they put a nice spiral on that ball, and he was wide open, and the referee confirms that's a touchdown Team Florida. Team Florida is trying to make their way up the ladder. You lose, you go home. You win, you stay in. And I can hear in the side of my ear, we've got another guest caller and one of our partners, Emerson Martin, coming up. Throws to the outside. Looks like the referee's going to give it to him. Yes, it is. It's number 9 making that catch, Dontell Green. Nice little out pattern. He gets the ball into the end zone and gets the extra point. That's 2 scores in a row. Team Florida's had the ball. Each time they've had it, they've scored. Well, let's see what the Hornets can do. The Hornets were talking it. Now they got the ball, and let's see if they can turn over some points. A little throw out the sideline is not going to get them much. Well, we've got another caller in, and this is one of my favorite people, one of our new partners. It's Emerson Martin.
Oh, you can't choose favorites now. You're going to make them all feel bad.
Hey, they're all my favorites. I love Emerson because he's so soft-spoken, and, you know, he used to do it to him on the football field at Pittsburgh, but soft-spoken, great heart, loves the kids, and got a great passion that I'm sure you'll talk about. So I will let you take it over, Ryan, and the Hornets have the ball. If they don't score now, they're going to be in trouble. Take it away.
Yes, sir. Emerson, can you hear me?
I can.
We are live from Jacksonville, Florida. We are freezing our tails off as the sun goes down. But once again, we've had plenty of conversations with guys that are in snow right now. And I don't know where you're located right now in the States, but if you look out the window right now, what's it look like?
Well, I'm in Baltimore, so looking out the window right now, there's snow on the ground. The sidewalks are covered in some places. The temperature is dropping. And we'll probably have some black ice later on tonight. So
Oh,
it's
man.
It's truly, truly cold. Woke up this morning at about 7 degrees.
Oh, man. That's, you know, you guys are making me feel bad because I'm out here talking about the 49-degree weather, and we can still see the grass on the ground. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome Emerson Martin, Players to Pro. As you can see, we got the logo up on the live stream. Emerson, have you had a chance to tune into the live stream at all?
Just a bit, not a whole lot. I'm very excited to see the games being played and seeing the athletes run around. So very excited about what we're doing and the 7-on-7 and all our tournaments and our league play, man. So it's really an exciting time.
Absolutely, and we just thank you for joining us today. And we're just going to jump right into it. I know we've had some previous conversations, and we've built a great relationship between the businesses and the foundation, and ultimately just the passion that we have with the student-athletes and the game of football. And I want the audience just to hear a little bit about yourself and why football has played such a big part in your life.
Well, I can take it back to my childhood. You know, I was a guy that, for whatever reason, loved to fight. And it's a funny story I often tell a lot of people, but a guy came to me and said, look, man, you can play football for me. And in between those lines, man, you can pretty much kill a guy. And the most you're going to get is 15 yards. So he told me that, and I was in. And it taught me a lot about life. It taught me about the challenges of life, you know, as a man. And as we go through life, we have to sometimes compare ourselves to the next man. And we have to rise above that challenge. Also, we fall down and we get hurt and we don't feel like getting up, but we have to get back up. So for me, there's no better teacher of life than the game of football. And I've just come to love it. I've been blessed to do it. It's taken me from the little small town of Elizabethtown to Hampton, Virginia, and to the Kansas City Chiefs, then to the Carolina Panthers, and just the Pittsburgh Steelers. So it has been truly who I am and what defines me and what makes me. And I thank God for making me this man.
Amen. And, you know, being able to play at all different levels of football, you're a witness to it all. And, you know, to transition into the passion and what you're doing now, let's get into it. Players to Pros. You know, you developed it. You know, what's the idea behind it? Let's talk about it.
Well, the idea behind Players to Pros is twofold. One is to build a relationship from guys that have played at a high level, whether it be football, basketball, baseball, the women's and men's track, softball, volleyball, whatever the sport may be. Those people that have achieved a high level understand what it's taken to get to that level. And then it gives those kids a mentor and connects those kids back together. So kids are able to connect with some of their childhood heroes, and then they're able to advise them and to direct them so they don't hit some of the pitfalls that they had to go to, and to give them exposure and to put them on a platform so we can help anybody from the small town of Elizabethtown to Dade, Florida, where everybody knows is one of those football meccas. So we can help guys from every avenue. They can put a profile, put the SAT and grades there, and they put a highlight film of whatever they may have, whether it be on YouTube or Huddle or any other means, and they'll take that video and plug it in. And we constantly contact universities and colleges across the country to give those kids exposure with the hopes that they will be able to take the athletic ability, and become a professional in life and get an education.
I love it. I love it. And I know something very close to your heart, being a former NFL player, you have a very special passion for NFL players and former NFL players. Can you explain what that is and how your new strategic partnership will help fulfill that passion?
Well, just today I was reading an article about some homeless guys and an article about where it was, out of 79 players that they researched, 76 of them had some type of brain damage. And a lot of times people don't understand, in order to give those guys a productive life, they have to do something that they love or something that keeps them moving and keeps them cognizant. Now, by by strategically partnering with Stealth and playing the recruiting game and HSPN and all those guys, all these the different avenues coming in together with NYFO and what we do with the 707 League, we're able to keep those guys invested in a sport that they love and to make and to turn their life around and be productive. At the same time, the benefits of Stealth Rating and PTRD are is unfathomable. It's one of those things that if kids at an early age get into the playing the recruiting game, they learn what the requirements are, what is expected of them, and then they learn how to strategically plan their career through high school so that colleges are attracted to them, along with the Stealth Rating. And what we're doing with Stealth Rating is so exciting because we're able to give camps in a way that's never been done before. We will be able to, colleges can live stream as we take those kids through the combines and throughout the workouts, and colleges will actually be able to recruit, and we'll be able to verify transcripts, verify these guys as being PTRG certified, meaning their character and everything is great for what the colleges are looking for, and they know what kind of athlete they're getting. And so we do all those things to help those kids reach the next level, and putting all of that together is going to make for a better game being played. It's going to make for a better product of athletes being put on the field, and ultimately it's going to transition up to the NFL where we got high character guys that gives us that take care of the brand and the image of the NFL, then it can transition at the end of it back into what we did.
Outstanding things going on. I know you're talking about the partnership between playing the recruiting game. Ladies and gentlemen, if you tuned in earlier in the broadcast, two of our main sponsors are playingtherecruitinggame.com and Stealth Rating. And that partnership, once again, you're covering all bases. When you're talking about the student athlete, the character, and most importantly, it's outstanding to hear, just being here at the 7v7, the parents come up and the coaches come up and they're asking, where can I watch the stream? Where can I see it? Well, 98% of everything that we do is internet-based. So when we're talking about those colleges and being able to promote these student athletes, a lot of these universities and colleges and a lot of people in general, their budget is maybe their phone, their cell phone. And, as we're talking right now, you can pull up the game, the live feed of the game, and you can check it out. And I want to jump over, as you're talking about, this partnership, I also want to jump over to Players to Pros, myp2pwall.com. We got the website up right now, Emerson. I know you were talking briefly about it before, but if you could just kind of walk us through. We're on the homepage, and we can see, get on the wall, the news feed. Can you just walk us through the homepage for us?
Well, if you look on the homepage, as these athletes come on board, you'll see their faces, and it'll be streaming through. So if you're looking at the front page, you see these athletes flipping through. The next step will be to sign on or to sign in. Once you sign in, or you start an account or sign up. Once you click on that, you can sign up in different ways. You can use your Facebook profile to sign up, or you can just start a new profile and sign up and put those things in it. As you're going through the profile, you'll sign up as a player, a pro, a coach, or press, anybody that's affiliated with sports. You're able to come in and be a part of our page. So you will sign in. And then it's all like Facebook. You interact with the kids in your area for those pros that are doing workout camps and things of that nature in the different respective areas. They can post it in our calendar so that kids can find it. They can actually start blogs within there to find out what kids are doing, what's going on, who's where, who's going where. So there's a lot of things to do where they can be interactive with one another and see what's going on around the country.
Awesome things you got going on, and once again, we wish you were here with us out in this somewhat more decent weather than up in Baltimore. But once again, Emerson, we thank you so much for tuning in, and not only just tuning in today, but everything that you're doing for the foundation and the companies and the partnerships that we've acquired just recently. Any last words for the viewing audience out there?
The best is yet to come. Just look forward to being a part of our Stealth camps, our national championship, which is going to be coming up down in Hollywood, Florida, on June the 11th. Excited about that and some of the tournaments that we're going to be having. So stay tuned. Watch our Steph camps and watch the production that we put on and college coaches that are out there that are looking for those kids from all across the country. You know, give us a call. Let's tell you how to be a part of what we got going on and what's going to be what area we're going to be moving into. So it's such an exciting time, and the possibilities are limitless.
Absolutely, and you can also find out more information on Players to Pros social media. You can follow them at Players2Pros, and also you can feature the website. Go to www.myp2pwall.com. You can check it out, find more information. And once again, this is Emerson Martin coming to you live from Baltimore, and we hope the best up there. Stay warm. And thanks so much, Emerson, for joining us today.
Absolutely, Ron. Thank you, man. Look forward to talking to you soon.
Okay, we'll talk to you later. Thanks so much.
All right, bye-bye.
And once again, Emerson Martin, all the way up in Baltimore. Hey, it's not as bad down here, I would say. So how's it over there on the sideline, Glenn?
Well, it's getting chilly, and I'm meeting some really cool coaches talking about the events we're having in just meeting some really interesting. As a matter of fact, put a headset on one of the coaches that I just was able to meet, and he was able to listen to Emerson and, you know, giving his thumbs up. But I'll tell you what, some high-flying action. Team Florida is lighting it up. And the guys on the sideline, I'm on the sideline with the opposing team, the Hornets, and it's a little quiet over here.
It is.
Because the Team Florida is lighting them up. They're catching them in the corner. They're catching them in the middle. They're catching them on the side. And they're getting the ball in the end zone. So, you know, the guys are looking at me now. We are live, and we're live all across the nation. But these are all a great group of kids, okay? And they're trying just as hard. But, you know, they're probably going to be eliminated. It's a local team. The Hornets are a Jacksonville team. And Team Florida is getting teed up. So I can tell you, I'm up and moving around. It's the temperature is dropping. It is. We've talked about it enough, but you know you're going to hear that from us. Being from South Florida, we're just not used to this, and it's not in our blood. It's not in our blood, but very interesting to be able to stand here and listen to you and listen to Emerson, and you know, like a brother from another mother. Just what a warm heart, and you know, such passion with the what he does and what he stands for, and I'm just. I'm proud to be a partner of his and Bob Winstead, and we're just looking forward to, as you know, we're looking forward to going across the country and broadcasting and letting these kids know what's up. It was just amazing, Ryan, because I got to talk to a coach over here. We were exchanging Twitter, and he was listening in, but most importantly, he worked on a couple of our sites, and he said, "You don't really do this," and I said, "Well, hit that button there, HSPN," and brought it up, and he saw the live stream, and he could hear, I could hear the background, and he just, you know, shook his head, says, "Man, I want to make it down to your May 2nd tournament. Is it open?" I said, "Yeah, it's open." He said, "It's open for all the kids, but what we had that's special is a week after that, we have the camp and combines where we have to focus on the academic mentoring." And I said, "Coach, this is the carrot, okay? We go after the educational aspect of the character of these young men and making sure they get it to the next level." Well, he loved it. He's going to be down there. I'm looking at the players coming off the field. Team Florida advances again, and I've got a couple more teams that are going to be coming up in front of us. But you know what, folks? We're getting ready for the prime time that's coming in front of us. We're going to give you as much information as we can for these players because we want to make sure they get on the map, and we've got enough coaches around the country that are watching, and we appreciate the coaches that are following us. And we blast out emails to over 12,000 of you, and we've got over 600 of them that follow us on a regular basis. So all those coaches around the country that are in those small schools that are looking for players, yep, these are high flyers. There are a bunch of them committed, but there's a whole bunch of them that aren't committed. And you just saw a bunch of them for the Hornets can play at any level, and these young men have the grades, and that's important for them to have the grades. So I see the Florida Fire down there doing some chest pumps, so they must be lighting up as well. We're getting close. We're getting close to the final, and it's it's a shame that it went on so late, because this temperature is dropping and I can't even look forward to breaking this stuff down in the dark, Ryan.
Yep. Yeah, it'll be interesting. A great crew out here.
Holy moly.
At the field. I was had an opportunity to come out here this morning and hang out with these guys, so I'm sure they'll keep the lights on for us as long as possible, hopefully. But yeah, we've got a couple games going on, and believe it or not, it has quieted down a bit because the crowd is leaving, because there's less and less teams. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is a single elimination round. You are tuned in to HSPNSports.com live broadcast feed of the First Coast Invitational, hosted by Drayton Florence, former San Diego and Carolina Panther. Doing some outstanding things for the kids, not only in the area, but surrounding areas. We're talking the whole Southeastern Conference. Eliminating teams left and right, but ultimately we're going to knock it out. We're going to get this championship game right in on center field, field right in front of us. But as you can see, we've got a game going on right now. And we want to take some time to recognize the people and the companies and the foundations that have brought this broadcast to you today. And we're going to take a second to recognize our sponsors. KDA, Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation, www.kdafoundation.org. You can also find them at Twitter, KDA Productions. To change one life, change a generation by educating, preparing, mentoring, and teaching our students, both athletes and non-athletes. Great foundation, great things going on. We appreciate what you're doing for the students. PTRG, Playing the Recruiting Game. www.playingtherecruitinggame.com. You can also follow them at Twitter at Recruiting Game, the first patented web-based learning management system that teaches the student athlete to apply a business approach to the recruiting process. Once again, you can find that information at www.playingtherecruitinggame.com. Going right down on the list, Stealth Rating, acronym Students Taking Education, Athletics, and Life to Heart. You can find information at www.stealthrating.com, also on Twitter at Stealth Ranking, a rating service that measures what college coaches are actually looking for. And last but never least, we got a company out there. We don't have their logo up, but the Elite 7v7. You heard Emerson Martin talk about it. The Elite 7v7 tournament coming up right around the corner. We got some great dates, the quarterfinals, semifinals, and the national championship down in South Florida. Don't be surprised when you see the majority of the teams that are out here today at the same competition. So once again, we thank all of our sponsors that have put on this broadcast for us today. And we want to give a big shout out to OhBoySports.com for putting on this tent. We are broadcasting live from the Oh Boy Sports media tent. And we thank them for coming out and supporting not only HSBN Sports, but coming out and supporting the Keaton Dreams Alive Foundation and the First Coast Invitational by Drayton Florence. We're going to take a quick break and get you back to the action, but stay with us. You're watching it live from Jacksonville, Florida, HSBNSports.com.
Thank you. Who's that to?
Well, here we are live back in Jacksonville, Florida. It's been a pleasure. I had a crowd behind me and some people coming up to me saying the mayor is here. And I said, well, bring the mayor over for our little 7-on-7 that we got here with Drayton Florence and his Drayton Florence Foundation. Mayor Alvin Brown, it's so nice to meet you. And we were just talking earlier. Tell us some of the great things that are going on in Jacksonville that you'd like people to know. People are watching us all over the country. And we're streaming it, so tell us some good things about Jacksonville.
Jacksonville is on the move, you know. We've got a lot of good things going on, more jobs here. We're 36,000 new jobs. We're the number one city if you want to start a business. We got a downtown that's thriving and doing well. And we have a great sport and entertainment division here in the city. I believe in sports. I think it speaks to the game of life. And I'm happy to be here at Sheffield at this 7-on-7. I think it's great because I just got through talking to some of the football players who were playing, and I told them they're playing the game of life. This is about opportunity, and they have to have a focus. And the three things I talked about all over the city I talk about is you got to know your purpose, You got to have passion, and you got to know where your power comes from. So Jacksonville is a blessed city that has great, great people here, good business community, good faith-based community, good civic leaders, all working together to improve the quality of life, no matter what side of town you live on here in the city of Jacksonville.
I'm getting goosebumps just listening to you, man. And I know we have a friend in common, because before we went live and we started talking, I introduced myself to Alvin and the Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation, and brother from another mother, Silk Cozart, and Silk's best friend, and his brother, Martin Luther King. And you said you're a personal friend. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I've known Martin for at least 25 years, a great guy, salt of the earth. I had an opportunity to serve on the board of directors for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference when he was president. And I had an opportunity when I was running a foundation here to have Martin Luther King III, Coretta Scott King, Yolanda King, Bernice King all come to Jacksonville for my annual ML King breakfast to empower young people academically by writing an essay contest on how do you want to improve and really redeem Dr. King's dream. And so very close to Martin. He'll be here actually in a couple of weeks to Jacksonville, and I will let him know about the dream is being kept alive through the foundation.
Absolutely. And one of the core beliefs that we have, this is we call this the carrot, you know, to get them involved. But we're all about academic mentoring, and Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation is academic mentoring. We want to them to learn how to use their athletic ability, pay for a great education. So one of the things we do that we specialize in at HSPN, and my son Ryan Stout is over directing right now, is that we get all the coaches around the country that are at the small school, maybe the Ivy League schools, to tune in to watch these kids that are flying under the radar, we call them. Now, we're teaching them to put a number on that jersey because we can qualify them with their grades, their GPAs, their Pell Grants, because that's money out of another school, and identify these players like no one else does it. So what we do with KDA, and what we're connected, and we're just loving being with Drake and Florence, is his foundation as well. It's all about the kids for us. And to hear you and your passion and the freshness of what you bring into Jacksonville, man, I mean, I'm just ready. We just hung up with Emerson Martin. He's another one of my partners that played for Pittsburgh Steelers, and I'm listening to Emerson getting chills and his passion, and he's probably listening to us right now. And then Alvin walks up, Mayor, and we got all this exciting stuff going on. I want to thank you for what you're doing. And is there anything else you want to share with the folks around the nation about Jacksonville?
Sure. You know, Jacksonville is a great city, a very diverse city. It's the largest city in the country in terms of land-wise. And we have beaches. We have a great downtown on the St. John's River. But I'm big in sports and entertainment. So this field that we're playing on today, I cut the ribbon on this field a couple of years ago because I use sports as a way of really mentoring and nurturing young athletes. We've launched the Mayor's Mentors Program. I have 600 caring adults mentoring young people. So I use sports as a way of connecting. And I think what you're doing is great. I'm very proud to know that you're doing it right here in the great city of Jacksonville. And I look forward to working with you and the Drayton Foundation, because at the end of the day, it is empowering the next generation of young people with the purpose that God has for their life. Get up every day with passion and know where their power comes from.
Amen to that, brother. And it's a breath of fresh air. I'm freezing my South Florida butt off, but it's a breath of fresh air, and I'm so glad and proud to meet you and be standing with you. And you said history, because this is a history making event for us, and we're getting ready, and people around the country are looking at Jacksonville now, and Emerson and Bob Winston and Silk and I are looking at bringing a big state championship, national championship, and we're looking for that city, and it may just be Jacksonville, bro.
Jacksonville is the way to be. I can guarantee you right now live that I will partner with you. I'll have my director of sports and entertainment, Dave Harrell, reach out to you, and we can figure out a partnership. I mean, we are big and sports and entertainment. He's right now in Little Rock at an NCAA women's basketball game. So I am telling you, you're at the right place at the right time. And this is how God works. He brings his people together to support causes that really make it happen for young people.
Well, it'll be about 200 teams. It'll be next summer. And I can guarantee you that Emerson and Bob, who are watching right now, are standing up, and I can feel it. Silk, my brother Silk, is going crazy because they're being courted by a couple of cities, and in comes the mayor, and it doesn't happen by chance, my brother. And I thank you so much for taking this time and invigorating me, warming my heart, and I need to warm up because the temperature is going down, and I'm looking forward to talking to you in the near future.
Look forward to it. Likewise. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. God bless you. And the mayor of Jacksonville joining us, inspiring the young men, and that was a local team that he was talking to, the Hornets. The Hornets got their given to them, but it's not about the wins and the losses. It's about getting out there and doing it, having passion, and using it as a tool to get somewhere else. I'm going to bring it back to you, Ryan. I know I can hear the phone ringing on the other end of the line, and I thank you so much for being with me and all the things you're doing. You're going to hear from us, and we're going to hear from you. Thank you very much. This is Glenn Stout live with HSPN Sports in Jacksonville, Florida.
Yes, sir. Awesome job on the sidelines. We still got some action, and the weather is, the temperature is dropping. We got some action on three fields, and it is getting quieter because the teams are falling out. Yes, we are in the single elimination rounds of the First Coast Invitational today. We got all types of action going on, and hopefully these lights can hold up because the sun has dropped and the temperature has dropped. Once again, you're joining us with Ryan Stout and Glenn Stout. We are broadcasting live from Jacksonville, Florida, and we got some action. I'm going to cut myself off. We got some crazy action going down there at the far side of the field. We probably got a real close game, and once again, this is the elimination round, so anything can happen at this point. And we're going to get to witness live the championship game right in front of us. We got cameras all over these fields. But ultimately, we thank you for joining us. Glenn Stout on the sideline. Ryan Stout in the booth in the OhBoySports.com media tent doing some awesome things. We're going to take a quick break and get right back to the action.
Hey, good running out there, boy. Me?
Come on.
And once again, want to recognize our partners for today. Sponsors and partners, KDA Foundation, the Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation. You can follow them on social media, Twitter, at KDA Productions. To change one life, change a generation by educating, preparing, mentoring, and teaching our students, both athletes and non-athletes. Instilling in our students the skills necessary for character success, academic success, and performing success, so that they may be college and career ready to thrive in the corporate world, design their own financial future, and give back to their communities through service. To find more information, you can find us at www.kdafoundation.org. PTRG, playing the recruiting game. You can follow us at social media at recruiting game, the first patented web-based learning management system that teaches the student athlete to apply a business approach to the recruiting process. Learn the strategies of turning hard work on and off the field into money for college. To find out more information and to sign up, you can visit www.playingtherecruitinggame.com. Stealth Rating. It is an acronym, Students Taking Education, Athletics, and Life to Heart. You can follow them on Twitter at Stealth Ranking. We are a rating service that measures what college coaches are actually looking for. Imagine for a moment what it would be like to recruit student athletes that you knew before they landed on campus, that they had the ability to transition successfully to a college environment, succeed in the classroom, had a great work ethic on the field. Stealth Rating at stealthrating.com. www.stealthrating.com. And last but never least, we don't have the logo up, but we're going to talk about it anyway. The Elite 7v7. The Elite 7v7 National Football Association opens its season this year on March 14th at MacArthur High School in Hollywood, Florida, with the South Florida Elite 7v7 Classic Tournament Series. The South Florida Elite 7v7 Classic looks to be the premier Florida event of the year, located in the mecca of 7v7 football, South Florida. Following the March 14th Classic will be the April 11th Regional Quarterfinal, the May 2nd Spring Qualifier, the June 6th State Championship, then the July 11th National Championship. To find more information, you can visit us at www.elite7v7.com.
Thanks for noticing. I really appreciate that. Did this ain't worth the $50. Get up! Huh? Is it done? Oh, shit. Last game, the semifinal?
I think so, yeah.
Oh my God.
I think so.
It's so cold. I just want to go home. Thank you.
I said, call Jasmine, make sure she's on.
Hey, your mic is live. Thank you.
now we 3 hours out. I only thought we were like an hour away.
Let's go! is the game going to be over?
Can you have my mom come get this blanket?
Offense! Offense!
Yo, what the fuck's up with this game, man? This game taking an hour. This game's like taking an hour. Like, this game's taking forever, man. When is the other dude coming up?
Come on. Do that. It's my life right here.
Hey, Oh, Hey, coach, you better go.
What a day and what a night. Probably in the upper 40s, coldest I've felt in a long time. Got quilts on. We're ready for the final game. Team Florida has brought it to Jacksonville. They are going to be in the finals against Strong Arm, which is a South Florida team. Great interview earlier with Mayor Alvin Cook. What a man with a great heart, bringing athletics to the intramurals and a little older, and using it as a tool just like we do at Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation. This is the big one. This is the Drayton Florence Foundation championship game for the championship down here or up here in Jacksonville, Florida. I'm Glenn Stout with Ryan Stout. And
yes, sir.
We've got a lot of people that have been hunkering down and jumping back on those cameras. And
we've been taking shifts.
In and out of the heater of the car.
Well, at this point in time in the tournament, you know, there's enough teams in the event that are eliminated that, you know, I told my guys, hey, let's take a couple shifts, you know. Get these guys freshed up because guess what? Championship game is about to be underway. We got Strong Arm warming up right now in the screen. Boom.
Getting ready to go prime time. And we're ready. If you're ready, if you're still with us, and probably got to get somebody out there in the Twitter world that will tweet it to let people know that, heck, it was supposed to happen at 6 o'clock. I don't know what time it is, but it ain't 6 o'clock. And Ryan is going to put out a tweet now, and let's get these people out here watching because this is primetime football. Jacksonville, Florida, Strong Arm playing in the championship against Team Florida. And they're right out here in front of me getting warmed up. And amazing to me. They put on a couple of sweatshirts. They still got shorts on. And every breath is fog, and they're getting ready to rumble, getting ready to do this thing. And we're going prime time. So we're hoping everybody stayed with us. And if you didn't and you're watching a recording of this, well, good for you. But we talked to these young men early on. Coach, head coach Martin, the sponsor of Strong Arm, brought the team all the way up from Dade County, and Team Florida came across the coast, and they're getting ready to go. We're going primetime right now. It's live here in Jacksonville, Florida. Strong Arm got the ball first. First and 10, they'll start the clock. This is the championship, folks. This is for the trophy and the bragging rights. Impact players once again. Team Florida, number one, Dejon Johnson, 2016 graduate. Number two, Jalen Williams, 2018. Number eight, Austin Casey, 2017. Number 21, Jimmy Fox, 2016. And number 24, Nate Dement. He's a 2016 graduate. I'll have the Strong Arm for you. A couple of impact players, Antoine Webster, number 86, and Montre Smith. We don't have his number. You've got Coach Martin and Coach Tunsil that are coaching these teams. So let's get ready to rumble. We'll wrap this thing up and get a championship in the books. Little out pattern right up front, picks up about four or five. And they are moving the sticks. Actually, they're moving the QBT. Everybody is gone today, running way over time. But these young guys don't care because they're in here to win it, bring that big trophy home. Quarterback's back. He's looking down the corner of the field. It's going to be just overthrown. Outstretched hands. Little more air under the ball, and he probably would have had it. Put it on a line. It was number two for Strong Arm. We don't have a roster for them. They've been playing all day long, and this one's for the trophy. Throws a dart over the middle. Almost picked off by Team Florida. You can tell the cold is having an effect on these players.
Yeah, you got to admit, some of these guys have been out here since 10 a.m. this morning.
Yeah, and they've traveled a long ways. And shoot, it started out in the 40s, and I guarantee it's in the 40s right now, too. And these guys from South Florida are feeling it. But they're young, and they got the adrenaline flowing. So here we go, third down. Quarterback's looking to the right side. He's looking over here to the right side all the way. He's got a receiver wide open. Touchdown, number two. Strong arm takes the first touchdown of the game on third down. It was about a 30-yard throw. Great catch by the young man.
I didn't get the
lining it up for the extra point.
He got it, right?
First score on the table for the championship game. Team Florida has been running around doing most of the high five, and it quieted them down a little bit. They're the first ones to score tonight. Strong arm. Looking both ways. And darts a bullet over into the corner. Extra point is good. Strong arm goes up on their first possession. And it'll be important for each one of them to have a possession to score. That's the way it's going to look. Team Florida with the offensive ball in the first series for them. It's going to be a must-score situation for him. He's looking over the middle. Great catch by number 11. Trying to get to the corner with some great moves. Spins around. My goodness, you talk about a scat back. That young man is all over the place. Wow. Team Florida has some very impressive young players out here today. We've caught them for a couple of games already right here on the feature field. 1B. The first Coast Invitational Championship game, Team Florida against Strong Arm. First down. Throwing it over here to the right side. He picks up about 5-6 yards. Number 19, you can see him. Brings it out to the 9-yard line. Second down, Team Florida lines it up. Looking right all the way, a little out pattern, and it's dropped. But boy, that was a touchdown if he kept a hold on it. A little flat underneath. And he had the end zone. They got third down. Going to have to score every time they get the ball. Looking left all the way. Nobody open. Throws a dart in the middle. It's incomplete. Almost picked off. That'll bring up fourth down. They have to score. They don't score, it's going to be trouble. Strong arm will get the ball back on offense. Very potent offense. Strong arm's in a prevent type of a defense. Got all of their defenders on the goal line. Obviously, Team Florida has to get it in the goal line so they can just sit back at the goal line. Time will be a factor. It's picked off in the end zone, and Team Florida does not convert a touchdown. Strong arm will get the ball back, and look out. Strong arm is used to closing these things out, and they're doing a job on it, picking the ball off in the end zone and getting the ball back. Quarterback brings him up, strong arm. He's looking right. Throws it right over the middle. Referee just blows the whistle. First man doesn't get him. Looks like it's probably a first down. What's interesting is the coaches can go in there and looks like can give them a play. Got twins stacked on each side. Trying to open up the middle, but goes to the outside left. That's a touchdown, strong arm. Second touchdown in the second series. Get his number, I'm sure you got it before I did. I'm down here at field level. Going for their extra point and could be trouble. They've taken 7-on-7 and scale offenses to a different level, to a championship level. Strong arms making it look easy. Quarterback rolling to the right-hand side. He throws it to a wide-open receiver. Extra point is good. Strong arm goes up by two scores on two possessions. Team Florida doesn't get one in. It's going to be a problem. I see Drayton Florence over here. Drayton Florence Foundation. I was going to grab him, but I'm holding on to a quilt. Well, Team Florida throws a little one over the middle, only picks up a couple yards. Pick up second down and 8 or 9 yards, but it doesn't matter. You've got to score every possession. Quarterback's looking right all the way. Now he's back over the center of the field. Wide open receiver. It's number one. Picks up a first down. They get 4 seconds to get rid of the ball. That tee they're using has got a timer on it. And that buzzer will go off. Yeah, that quarterback takes more than 4 seconds, and it was pretty close to the 4-second mark. Team Florida must score situation. Quarterback's looking right underneath. He's going to throw it. Number 11, does he get in? My goodness gracious. They call that a touchdown, and you've got four strong-arm defenders around him. Not sure if they stuck their hands out or not, but the coaches can't believe it. But the referees and giving a signal, it's a touchdown. Yep, they're going to keep it a touchdown. Number 11, Scatback, gets in through between four or five defenders. And it didn't look like anybody put their hands on them, at least the referees didn't signal it. They signal a touchdown. Here we go with the extra point. They'll need this extra point. Be one score down. And there you go. Number 9 makes a great catch. Great throw by the quarterback. They're one score down. Team Florida comes back on their second series now. They're going to need to hold them. Because if strong arm scores every time they have possession, there's no way they'll be able to catch him. Well, Ryan, there's a few people out here. The Ducks have flown south. And my goodness gracious, not only is it cold, but the dew is dropping in.
Yes, sir. It is it's getting to that point. And you can see people are kind of looking around saying, hey, where's that running clock?
Wow, what a move. Great move. Number 6, close to the first down. Not the crowd we had out here today, but I don't think this championship game was supposed to happen at around 6, 6:30. So, yeah, it's a few hours over. Quarterback looking left. He pump fakes, throws a dart over the middle. There's no whistle. There's number two again. Picked up a first down. Nobody wanted to touch him. First down about 9 yards for the touchdown. Maybe called for too much time. Looking right all the way, little slant in between the slot player. Wasn't a pick, but it sure did work well. Strong arm scores their third touchdown of the night. Going for the extra point. Got him stacked up down here on the bottom side. Crossing him up, throws it back to the corner end zone. It's a jump ball, and Team Florida will pick it off so they don't get the extra point. A little opening, but then again, strong arm scores every time they have the ball. Team Florida won't have a chance for coming back. Well, we got some hardcore cameramen up there in the towers, Bob Webster and Justin Van Dyke, that have just been up there all day in the cold. Team Florida gets enough for a first down. Two halves in the game. I don't know if you can hear the coaches, but I'm on the strong arm sideline. Barking out signals to their defense. Wow. Little throw out to the left side. Ball's got to be hard. Hands got to be cold. Slipped out. It's a good thing it wasn't a tip and a pick. Got a score on this possession. Throws it underneath. Not going to get much at all. It'll be fourth down. And I guarantee you the strong arm will be playing back. Got to pick up 3 yards for the first. Biggest play of the night of the day for Team Florida. They've got to convert here. If they don't convert, it's going to be very difficult to stay in this game. Throws it deep down the left-hand side. He overthrows it, almost an acrobatic catch. My goodness. Put a little air on it, and that may have been a catch. That was a very athletic play by the wide receiver, but it's a no-go. And that could mean the end of it. Strong arm is probably going to score every time they touch the ball.
Set.
Gone. She's going deep down the right-hand side. Almost a great catch. Fender puts his hands on him. Wow. That could have been caught. Great throw by the quarterback. Feel like I'm out here calling the game in Green Bay, Wisconsin, watching these players. Every time they breathe, blow smoke, and then I'm looking at myself in the mic, blowing smoke when I'm calling this game.
Well, it's not even the hot breath. It's the cold breath, too.
Oh, my goodness. It's a nice short throw over the left side, making some great moves out there. Well, we head back down to South Florida next week. The Elite 7v7, South Florida Classic is a Florida qualifier on Saturday. And then the week after that is our Stealth Camp Series on the 21st. Both of them at MacArthur High School. Stealth Camp Series includes playing a recruiting game and stealth rating before the combine in the camp. And then we will be covering it live as well. And we still invite those seniors because there's still slots available around the country at lower division schools and NAIA schools. They'll be recruiting these student athletes all the way through summertime. And we want to make sure we keep a spotlight on them. That's the Stealth Camp Series, March 21st, live on HSPN Sports, South Florida. I'm Glenn Stout. I'm here with Ryan Stout, Erica Van Dyke, and Jordan Van Dyke, and Bob Webster and Justin Van Dyke. One big family and all volunteering and out here at the KDA Foundation. Big slant, quick fire. Touchdown, strong arm. Quarterback took one step, threw a bullet, three-step plant on that slant, and the ball was there. Touchdown, strong arm. The momentum in the air has come out of Team Florida's sail. Compound that with cold weather, and there's a jump ball, incomplete, and it gotten very quiet. Well, Team Florida has the ball. Need to score and a couple turnovers. Found my chair, got my quilt, could use a big fire. Funny, because we've been taking breaks in the car with the heater on. Couldn't do that in the garage. Team Florida throws a little bitty angle route across the middle. They're going to need a lot more than that. Need to score, 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 and then have some turnovers to have any chance at this championship. I think both these teams were in Las Vegas for a tournament last weekend. 7-on-7 action at the showcase level gotten very, very big. Deep throw in the back of the end zone. Great defensive play. That may be a pick. Oh, he's calling it incomplete. Not pick, but wow. That was some athletic ability. Nice high throw into the end zone. Corner just went up and knocked it right out of the hands. Incomplete pass. No penalty flag. Bring up, I believe, fourth down. Team Florida brings it up. Going to need to score on this. Quarterback's looking right all the way. There's a little throw out to the right-hand side. Championship game tonight under the lights. First Coast Invitational, Drayton Florence Foundation. Team Florida versus Strong Arm. Throw underneath, and that's a see the signal by the referee. They're looking at each other. Touchdown, Team Florida. Pretty delayed. Extra point. It's good. The Strong Arm will get the ball back. Looks like they may be putting in a new quarterback. Quarterback has sandals on, so the starting quarterback is done for the day and the evening. We've got plenty of points on the board. And I was mistaken. That was for the touchdown. They didn't give them the touchdown beforehand. Although they signaled it, they must have given it to them at the one-yard line. Great catch. That's what they call. Extra points, good. Great, great catch. Number nine. Very athletic. Here we go, Strong Arm back on offense. Whistles everywhere.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Cool.
looking deep down the right-hand side. It's a big ball going up, and there's a little pushing and shoving. The referees don't call anything, but there was definitely some pushing and shoving. If they weren't out so far ahead, they probably would have called the flag on that if it had been a closer game. Team Florida had a good series today. We didn't see much of strong arm. They were opposite fields. Throws it deep down the left-hand side. Another jump ball. Incomplete. Just kind of throwing it up anywhere now. Fog's rolling in, which means moisture. Deep down the right-hand side, throws it straight up. Ball's knocked down. The turnover on downs. Team Florida, I believe, will get the ball now. Hey, if you're still watching us live, we do appreciate it. This is HSPNSports.com. Glenn Stout with Ryan Stout, Director of Broadcasting. Erica Lane, Justin Van Dyke, Jordan Van Dyke, and Bob Webster on the main cameras tonight and today. Heading back to South Florida tomorrow. Hopefully, it's in the 80s. We can thaw out. Team Florida has the ball, and Strong Arm is sitting back at the goal line. This one is pretty much over, folks. They're playing for pride now. Got a Team Florida player, wide receiver, limping around out there. Goes over the middle. He's going to try to get to the edge. Well, it's a big day of football, and these young men have fought hard, and Team Florida had some great games. It ends up pretty late at night, but look at Strong Arm. I love it. They got the bomb or something going on, and, you know, what a great day. We had great interviews from our folks from around the nation, all the people that are supporting us, all the way out to Los Angeles, California, Jeff Fisher, and up to Virginia is Bob Smith, and got a chance to talk to partner Emerson Martin, and he's up in Baltimore today, I believe, and my goodness, Lazaro Suarez down in Miami, and we got to reach around the whole nation and had some things early on because they were cranking up the internet. We got enough tech people out here. Our back-end guys were here, but great football, great camaraderie. Drayton Florence put on a great show today with the Drayton Florence Foundation. And, this was a free event. These teams came in, and they've got to spend a lot of money to get here. But my final thoughts today, bringing it from Jacksonville, Florida, is way too cold for touch football for me. And
bones are aching.
I will leave it at that. I don't see Drayton around here anywhere. So I guess we're going to call it at that, Ryan.
Yes, sir.
We had a great night tonight. And once again, I want to thank everyone for watching us. I want to thank our entire crew, Bob Webster on the main camera, Justin Van Dyke on the end zone camera, Jordan Van Dyke on the middle tower filming 1A, and Brian Stout, director of broadcasting, Erica Lane running around here like a chicken with her head cut off trying to get me rosters, numbers, and impact players, Janaea Van Dyke doing all of our social media, and early, if you were with us early in the day, we had Jasmine Van Dyke here interviewing student athletes. So all in all, it's been a fantastic day for us. Time to pack this thing up and get the heater on and get down south where the Ducks are.
Yes, sir, and we'll call it at that. Once again, this is Glenn Stout and Ryan Stout here at the First Coast Invitational brought to you by Drayton Florence. Outstanding tournament today. We thank you all for tuning in with us. We thank all of our sponsors, Keeping Dreams Alive Foundation, PlayingTheRecruitingGame.com, Stealth Rating, Elite 7v7 NFA, and also we want to shout out to our partners, Bleacher.com, Nation's Best Football, High School Football America, Florida Varsity, NYFO, and Player to Pros. Once again, we thank you for joining us live from Jacksonville, Florida. You're watching HSPNSports.com. We'll catch you next time.